God is realigning us to His purpose. He is faithful. That which He began, He will complete in your life and in my life. Well, I want to bring you some good news. That is, as Thomas was looking for proof, said, I won't believe, I want proof, I want to put my finger into his nails, the wounds, and I want to touch his side. As Thomas was speaking out like that, suddenly proof came looking for Thomas. That's what 2026 is about. John 20:26, the living proof came looking for Thomas. He met that confused, frustrated followers that night. You know, it struck me that all heaven was waiting to receive this Christ. They were all waiting to receive the Christ back to his glorious state. But Christ was condescending or humbling himself to go and be in a small prayer meeting with much less people than even here, just 11 people. Christ went. He looked for his disciples. He knew he had to get them back to him. It touched my heart that Jesus didn't send angels. He himself went looking for his disciples. And something very encouraging in verse 27, Jesus looked right at Thomas, the one who was fiercely loyal for Jesus but got lost in doubts. Jesus singles him out and in 20:27, and he said to Thomas, reach your finger here and look at my hands, and reach your hand here, put it into my side. Don't be unbelieving but believing. What is Jesus saying here? Jesus is in fact saying, friend Thomas, what is it going to take you? What is going to take you? What is it that's going to take to bring you back to faith and to allegiance to me? That's what Jesus is asking. What must Jesus do to help you and me to move away from our doubts and to believe again and again? To take us past the locked doors of our hearts. Discouragement is a locked door. When we are discouraged, it's a locked door. This morning a brother came with a slip of paper and he told me, I saw a dream. And I saw you feeling so burdened. But this morning I want to release every burden to the feet of the risen one. What will you do? What will you do with the burdens? Are you going to walk back away from this place of worship where the Christ is? In the midst of us, back with the load of burdens. What are you going to do with the burdens that you walked in with? So let's go past the locked doors of our heart of doubt and discouragement. Jesus wants to show up in your life and in my life. And he wants to affirm that you matter to God, that I matter to God. Never mind what your career is. Never mind from which family you come. Never mind what nationality you belong to. Never mind the abuse and the sorrow and the suffering that you may have gone through. Never mind. But the Lord, Jesus would have you know that you matter to God. There are so many who condemn themselves because you feel you have not walked with the Lord and you're not where you are. But this morning, there's hope for you. There's hope for you. The risen one is here to help you and to me to rise again. You know, friends, he will take you to the cross where he suffered cruel torture for you and for me. He will take you to his nail-scarred hands and say, this I did for you. He will take you, my friends, to that hole in his side where blood flowed from that pierced side and say, my heart was broken as that soldier speared my heart. It was broken because of your disobedience. and it is broken, that I may bring you back to obedience. Will you let this divine opportunity pass by this morning as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ 21 centuries ago, isn't it? I hope I'm getting my years right. So many years ago, we are celebrating. It's a past event, no doubt, but it bears to the today, to each of our lives. If we cannot keep it as a thing of history, it is relevant to our life, because there's power in a resurrected life. There's power in the risen Lord. There's power to touch every area of our life. Please don't just confine this to a message, to some words. Please relate it into your own life. And I pray this morning, if you have put a lock on the door of your heart and said, Jesus, this thus far and no further. Lord, you know that even as we have prayed and we have waited upon the Lord with this message, I know He will break through those windows and those doors that you may have self-locked from inside. But thanks be to God, He has the power to break through those and walk right into your life and say, peace be unto you. And call you to Himself. And when Thomas saw all that Jesus was offering him in the nail-pierced hands and the side, and as Thomas saw that, in verse 28, he cried out, My Lord and my God. He was saying, My Master and my Maker. And Thomas was saying, All I have, I give to you, because you gave it to me first. We are here gathering and worshipping because He gave it to us first. He gave His life to us first. He gave that pure life for each one of us. Thomas wanted his eyes to see and be certain of what he could commit the rest of his life to. And you know, tradition records that Thomas was the apostle who spearheaded the gospel in that great nation, our neighbors, India. It is said that he was martyred in India. Friends, Jesus calls us to move. Move. This is a time of shifting, a time of movement. Movement in our lives, movement in our spiritual life, movement in our ministry, movement in our career, movement in our family life, movement. If there is a rustling of the feathers, if there is a shifting, if there is difficulty, then there is movement. And in that movement, you know, something, doubts arise. But He doesn't mind the questions, because He knows the questions always lead to answers. He doesn't mind the doubts, because He knows we can be transformed from doubt to faith. From doubt to faith. What He wants from us, my brother, my sister, is that we may say, Lord, help my unbelief. That's what Thomas was saying. In those words, my Lord and my God, He said it all. He took the commission for the rest of His life, and He repented for the past, and He said, Lord, you did it all for me. Is God speaking to you this morning? Do you see the risen one standing in the room of your heart, wanting to transform from doubt to faith? You know, everything in this world we cannot plan out and say this much and this much and this much. We cannot measure everything. That Jesus calls us all, that we may walk in faith. We walk not by sight, but by faith, the scripture says. We are called to walk into a journey of faith, where we cannot spell out everything, where we may not be able to predict everything, but to trust our lives and trust our lives to the one who arose again from the dead. And Thomas is acknowledging the resurrected Jesus, who is omnipotent, meaning He possesses all power. Are you worshipping that Christ who is bigger than yourself? He is acknowledging the resurrected Jesus, who is omnipresent, being everywhere at the same time. Thomas is acknowledging the resurrected Jesus, who is omniscient, knowing, seeing everything. He is omnipotent. He has all power. He is omnipresent everywhere at the same time. He is omniscient, sees everything all the time. So at a time when what's happening around us is testing our faith, Jesus wants to show up behind the closed doors of our life and say, "See how I died for you," and call you to live for Him, my friends. Live a life fuller and more abundant and more prosperous and useful for yourself. That's the call of Jesus. He's calling us to lead a life that's bigger than yourself or myself. A life that is bigger. The end of it we cannot even see. The breadth of it is beyond our sense. He's calling us to a life that is bigger than ourselves. That is the message for me this resurrection morning. He's calling us to something we haven't done before. To trust Him all the way. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to conclude soon. What will it take for you to trust Him in faith in all the issues of your life? Your financial issues, Shalini prayed here about it. Your emotional issues, your spiritual battles, your sexual, relational, or even your marital, your situation with you in your family. What will it take you to trust God that He is able, that He can walk through a sealed door, He can break those seals and walk through? Hold on, hang on, my brother, my sister, hang on, hang on, hang on. Oftentimes I have seen in the ministry, I've served long enough to see that when relief is just at the corner, people let up and get angry with God and maybe get angry with you who ministered to them and walk away to a sad eternity. Hang on. Hang on. Last night evening, both of us were very moved because we were so emotionally broken because we heard of a young man who came for services maybe 5-6 years ago, who was in the high, I mean he had the world before him. And we ministered to him and helped him in life's difficult situations. But somehow or other, he missed it. And we heard last evening, at 42 years, he had died. We were so broken hearing of this. Oh God, we don't have to. You walk with Christ. Just don't let go at that point when it's going to turn around for you. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on, my brother, my sister, hold on. And John 20:29, Jesus looked down the centuries. He spoke that night to Thomas something. And while he looked down the centuries, he saw you and I. And he said, "Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen yet and yet have believed." Aren't you and I included in that? Aren't you and I included? He looked down the centuries. He saw beyond Thomas and he declared the purpose of God to Thomas that night and said, "More blessed are those who haven't seen and yet have believed." Aren't we in that situation? We never saw the physical crucifixion. We never saw the physical resurrection. But we have seen Jesus in our heart this morning. And we are alive to tell a story that He is the risen one. More blessed. More blessed. We are seated in the company of a people more blessed than Thomas and the apostles were. Don't limit your call. Don't limit your call. If you are willing, He is willing to take you to the highest places, maybe even in this land. God will take you. And we learned from Naomi Dowdy. She emphatically said, "There is no difference between sacred and spiritual." Didn't she say that? That was her call. In your life Maybe somewhere in this world's way, God will take you to the highest place that you may be His witness.